What's up, guys? It's cameraman Pokemon, and welcome to the final pre-release opening of Darkness Ablaze. Well, not the final one, because we still have six packs, but I'm going to open those up in a Poke Bingo with Agile Fox next Monday. So for today, we're cracking into these last two packs of Darkness Ablaze from Sword and Shield. And after that, it's just waiting for August 14th as we get a lot of product in. So if you're new to the channel and you're not subscribed yet, now is the time to do so. Hit that notification bell because we got a lot of Darkness Ablaze coming. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into these last two kits and get some nice pulls. Let's go. All right, guys, let's start with the first kit. Let's slide it open. We only need one more promo card for this pre-release kit, and that's the Arctosault. Can we get it? Ooh, another Decidueye. That's actually okay, because this is the most valuable and most playable card, I think. So not bad, but I hope in the last one we can get the Arctosault, because that gives us a set. You have the Kangaskhan, you have the Hydreigon, the Decidueye, and the Arctosault. So again, four different artworks. That is great, Pokemon. Thank you so much. We're doing Grimmsnarl first. And if you haven't seen my other pre-release kit openings, there's been already, I think, two videos on the channel. Go check those out. I'll leave them in the... Oh, we do the code card wrong. That's my bad. So this is a green code card. We're still doing the pack trick, but this probably means we don't get anything. But yeah, if you haven't seen those videos, check those out. And I get a great pull from every kit. So hopefully that's the same in this video as we walk away with two great pulls for Darkness Ablaze. And yeah, again, on August 14, guys, I am going all out with this set as we get a Swilos reverse. Hey, I don't have this one yet. The Melmetal rare. At least I don't think it has. So yeah, of course, Melmetal. The evolution of Melton that got introduced in Pokemon Go. I think it's an interesting one. Ash also used it in the anime for Sun and Moon in the end, and I think he actually beat a lot of people in the finals with Melmetal. So last second pack, Centiskorch. I hope I'm able to pull a Centiskorch, because that's definitely, I don't know, I really like the G-Max form, as it, you know, it becomes a huge snake-like centipede, and that just looks very awesome. So hopefully you can pull that one. We got a grass energy. Oh, look at this Flaffy. That is some awesome artwork from Kamiya. Very cool. Carnivine, big Parasol. I got this in a different version, and it might be in some videos, so you might want to check that out. Rookidee, we got Torchic, Trapinch, Jigglypuff, Ducklet. We got a Pinchurchin, and this is a reverse rare, and I already have this, but that is a great card to have in reverse rare. For the final card, we got a holo Kangaskhan. So at least we start off with a holo, and look at that Kangaskhan just flexing on us. Very cool. Let's look at Eternatus, see if Eternatus can bring the heat. And again, guys, I got a pull from every box so far, and I've seen a lot of people open their pre-release kits and getting some amazing pulls as well. So I think if you did not get any pre-release kits this time, it might be worth out trying to get them next time for the new set. And I think that got released. Yeah, the new set got released. I'm blanking a little bit on the name, but I'll highlight the logo on screen right now. But it's definitely going to be an electric set. That is what I remember. And I think we get the G-Max Pikachu as a card in that set. So that is also going to be a lot of fun to chase an ultra rare Pikachu, as we get a very cool Marini with Corsola that is gonna get wrecked by her. Last card, an Ampharos. Not too bad. And look how big that Ampharos is. Or the tree is very small, but it looks like a big Ampharos. So nothing yet. It's gonna come down to the Charizard pack again. Can we pull something? Of course, we got the holo, and that is not bad. It can officially be counted as a hit, but yeah, you want to get something a little bit better than a holo. So hopefully that is the case for this last pack. We got a Solrock, Steenee, an old PC. We got a Dino, Jigglypuff, Dunsparce, Clink, Marini, We got a Dartrix reverse. And for the last card, a Tasserina. So nothing too crazy, but I do like the artwork on that. Look at that. She's like on a beach in an exotic island. Very cool artwork. So we only got the Kangaskhan. So that was our only hit. Nothing to worry about. We still got one pack left, one kit left. Hopefully it's the Arcanine. Oh no, it's the Hydreigon. So I think I have two Hydreigons and two Decidueyes. If you have the Arcanine double and you want to trade for one of these, hit me up in the comments below or reach out to me on Twitter or Instagram in the DMs, because I would love to trade for an Arcanine. I think it's an Arcanine. At least it's one of the fossil Pokemon. So let's look at that. Let's throw, oh, that's all my trash on the side. Again, wow, Pokemon, this is, I feel like they put this in, yeah, with pot on it, because, you know, every time we have the different, four different artworks, so, yeah, let's do the same. So we start off with Grimmsnarl again. Can we get something from these last four packs? This pack feels chunky, it feels heavy. You know that feeling sometimes you have that you get something and it feels heavy? I'm not sure, you know, in the old days you could weigh the packs, but nowadays you can't with the different color code cards, but sometimes it still feels heavy. I have a friend that I open Pokemon cards with sometimes, and he is always checking the packs, feeling them out, and in most cases he's right. There is something special in the packs he's, you know, he thinks there's something in. So yeah, this one feels heavy. Are we in the same page? We got a Rose Tower. Can we also guess if there's something good in there? We do. Holy cow, look at this card. Eternatus VMAX. I think this is also a very playable, which means expensive, and of course an awesome looking card. It looks very clean. Let's look at the back. That is, I don't see anything wrong with it. Maybe a little bit more to the left, but wow. Eternatus VMAX. We already got a VMAX in my other opening, but now I have the Eternatus as well. Yes, I'm happy about that. So this already makes the opening. We still have three packs left. This doesn't feel chunky. So if we get something, don't get something in that, I think my theory has been proven. Of course it hasn't, but I don't know. It does feel chunky. And this one did feel like a little bit chunky. Maybe there was some air in there. I don't know, but it did feel a little bit more, yeah, weighty. I don't know, it's just weird. Glimwood Tangle, Leiron. We got a Parasect. Wow. Bunnelby. We got Vanillite. Gothita, we got Nickit, Shelmet, we got Pupitar. All right, can we get a Tyranitar Haul? That'd be dope. No, we get a Greedent. But again, I love it. You don't want to pull a Greedent, but I do like it's almost troll-like how much the artwork is just laughing at you. So, yeah, we're filling the packs. I don't want to fill the packs every time because I'm gonna mess up. So. There you go, another Larvitar. I'm already very happy with that Eternatus VMAX. That is an amazing pull. And we still have six more packs, which we're gonna do a Poke Bingo with Agile Fox. So who knows, there might be something more in there. We got Spikemuth, the Cape of Toughness, a Vibrava, Larvitar. We got Grimer, that is, I really like the artwork on the Grimer. Galarian Darumaka, we got a Sentret, we have a Rowlet, Pansage, AKA Grass Monkey, and ooh, yes, 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 it's the Tyranitar Hollow. Look at that. Yes, I love this card. There's some great hollows in this set as well. Darkrai and Melodic. Also, two hollows that I want to get. And this Tyranitar was definitely in that range. So, yes, two hits, in my opinion, from this opening already, from this kit. And if you haven't seen it, last Wednesday, I actually did an opening for Generation sets, where I got some amazing pulls. I might get something in this area, in this, yeah, this looking Pokemon. I might have something that in that range. So if you wanna see a little bit of an older opening, check that out. It's in the description below, Generations. As I butchered this last pack, can we get something from this last pack? I would love a Charizard. That would be nice to just get out of the way and not have to worry about that Charizard anymore. So. Let's go, guys. Hit that like button. We already got some amazing pulls, but let's hit that like button for some more luck. Swylus, Pupitar, we got Sinistee, Karrablast, We got Meltan, we got Marini, Purloin, we got a Poltergeist is an uncommon. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, I would have expected it to be a rare, but the last card, another holo, and also not a bad holo. Blaziken holo, look at that. Yes, I am very happy with our pre-release kits from Darkness Ablaze. We got some super amazing cards. And for today, man, that Eternatus VMAX, I'm not sure what it's worth. I'll probably highlight it on screen, but I think this is gonna be a very valuable card. So having that already is definitely fun. So I hope you enjoyed it. Look out for that Poke Bingo next Monday. Have an amazing weekend ahead. But this time, it's Cameraman Pokemon.